a small amount of flavor from the yeast that is applied. It converts sugar to alcohol and carbon dioxide.
If your raw materials all keep the max and look secure, then your beer will be clear and there'll be knocking at your door.
Malt is made from barley in three stages: steeping, germinating, and then kilning. See, that's the way of terminating. What was happening while we all were germinating? But let's go back to steeping. I'll explain it while we're waiting. There's 47 more verses. Steep the barley well in wool, just put it in thinly on the floor. Keep it warm and it will germinate in 7 days or more. Little shoots will start to shoot out, that start breaking down the grain. Then plug it in a nice hot kiln and kill it off again.
Now the temperature right here indicates the type of beer. About 90 degrees, keep it light as you please. But 100 thereabouts or even more will give you stout.
Now, during germination, something wonderful has changed. All the starch in the barley has begun to rearrange. All the enzymes are released to go running around and dashing to the next stage of the process, which is milling and then mashing.
Have you finished yet?
No. Now, the grain that is milled isn't thrown into a tun. That's a dirty grey container where the liquor is poured on. It's sort of like a tin bar, but the size of a small barge. And the words you need to know for this are grist, wort, mash and spud.
Let hot liquor start your grist. It's all turned to mash and mist. Let your enzymes loose and the sugar is produced. Drain it off and what you've got is a sweet liquid.
Well, actually, it's words. Well, nothing really rhymes with words. Except shirt and dirt. Lurt.
Get on with it.
Which is poured into a copper or a kettle with the hot, which is boiled in barley flame and at the point of the blue and rock, and then leaking into the potion, which, by the way, has now been cooled and put in burning tasting vessels, which is spotless and at all.
Down your neck.